Not sure what happened there, but my face froze. I'm not sure if the stream was still going out or not. But we managed to get the program start again. As you can see, the process lost quite a lot of space. About 30 odd places, if not more. Now heading towards corner 13. If you look on the minimap to the right, you can see the distinct break, the groups. This one goes out better this time. Don't have any gaps in the stream, any jittery playback. Certainly looks okay just now, but has only been running for just under 2 minutes. All the way is up, indeed, 12 turns to go. There's Dan Ashton to my left, on a Tron bike no less, from Rowan King. Dan also does a lot with the Everesting Facebook page. Oh, what? Drop out there. What? Come on. Okay, 1 second, because that's not happening, that's twice. So let's get rid of the Garmin power. Let's go on.
Vader.
You're not the best place to start, right, on a 14% corner. But that should be better now because we've never had any issues with the trainer dropping out, but that's on the last two rides actually. Had the pedals drop out, which is really strange because it never happened out on the road. It's not that I can see.
More blue and green, the power graph bottom now. Starting to suffer. Went too hard at the beginning because of the power issues. I wanted to catch up a little bit and really should have just rolled out the gate. Just put a stop over that counter of where we are. Certainly made us ride harder than we should have done. If anyone here pin corners to come.
Rider doing exactly the same as me, Tarmac Pro, on the lightweight wheels, Bilstein's lightest bike and the lightest wheels for climbing. Fortunately, this frame isn't. But we're lugging almost 81, in fact, just over 81 kilos up. Here we go, corner 10. Shit, drop the water bottle. Now I could jump off and get it. However, we're on a climb, so the wheels would come to a stop immediately. Fortunately, brought a spare. A little 14% bit. At this point, purely survival. Want to get to the top? We'll get to the top. We're not interested in how quick. Oh, corner 9. Under 6k to go now. Oh. By the way, not paid for. Well, by me it was. Not a promotion, however, OTE. Might send me some more of these wonderful duo bars. Help me. Future ventures. Feel free to do so. I'd love you to reach out to me. Great view there. Road ahead. There we go, corner 7. Oh. halfway towards corner six. Oh. This is a long segment. On the one hand, it's good to be able to just try and settle into a rhythm, but actually, those little false flats on the corners are a great little respite. Well, they are very short. Do unfortunately ruin your rhythm. It's at this point when you really want those corners to come. It starts to flatten. Earlier on in the ride, we would obviously change up a gear and keep the power on. Right now, I just need to spin. I'll try and relax the legs a little. Five more to go. My legs are goosed. Just basically grinding now. Get to the top. This little shallower bit just to recover slightly. Not changing up a gear. Take the pressure off the legs a little. Little 11% bump there. Oh man. Corner four, last three. 2.7k to go. If you watch the top middle as we roll past 15k, there you go, plus 40 XP. One of the things that Zwift has done, any of the Tour of Utopia rides, races, group rides, whatever, double XP. So, you want to try and gain yourself some extra XP, try and level up, get yourself one of the group rides, and as I say, get double XP whilst you're riding Tour of Utopia. Now it's only on the group rides and the races under the Tour of Utopia banner, so you've got to be wearing one of these jerseys, you've got to be in one of the events. Yeah, double XP. Get it while you can. Oh man. Again, three, quite a long segment. 2 is about 450 metres, and then about 500, 600 metres for the final segment. I think if I remember rightly, we reached the foot of the climb from the start banner, starting gate, in about 4 minutes, 5 minutes, was it? Can't remember. So anyway, we're approaching an hour's worth of climbing. And as you can look down the segments, the power, average power per segment has just been steadily tailing off, bit by bit, as the fatigue sets in. I can't believe Burgess is climbing on those wheels. That has just passed us with a disc wheel, heat rims, one of the heaviest sets in Zwift. Definitely not meant for climbing the Alp. Certainly climbing Alpe d'Huez is still on the bucket list at some point in the future. My partner's already ridden it. She hasn't ridden this version. Don't think she has any intention. I certainly want to see it for real. I'm obviously speaking to other Zwifters and other riders. I've done both. It's a pretty good replica that they've done. Okay, we're nearly at corner 3. 2 more corners, and then the final drag up to the finish line. Ugh. Oh. Meters. That's all we've got left. Here we go. Corner two. This is 600 meters. Normally I'd say we're fast approaching 1k to go, but there's nothing fast about this ride. Legs are shredded. Halfway, or over halfway to the final corner. Then we've got another, what, 600-700 meters drag up to the finish line. Here we go, that's 1 kilometre to go. Trying to balance finishing strong just now and just a also finishing. Don't want to go too hard. Go up for the final corner. Or indeed before the line. Here's the corner approaching. Starts to ease off a little. Ah.
500 now. Keep pushing. Here's the finish line. There we go. Lulatopia. Stage 3, group ride, Alpe de Zwift. 1 hour 15, start to finish. Not bad. Considering we had the power issue at the beginning with the sensors turning themselves off while we were trying to set the stream up. We had the two, or certainly the two that I noticed, the dropouts, the vectors. Then the third time that we stopped, transferring the power over to the trainer. Started 550 or whatever right at the back. Made our way up 50, the start of the climb. Went a bit too hard, we got up to 270. Had the power issues. Dropped back down at 350, and I think we finished there at 336 or 337 or somewhere around about there. So I'm pretty happy with that. Good solid workout. Yes, it went a little bit awry in some places. It went awry a little bit in some places, but do you know what? Pretty chuffed with that. Anyway, time to Let me get rid of that bike. We don't need the specialised anymore. Let's go. Let's go back on to our. What will we put on? How about a canyon? Do a canyon in. On the 7.8. Oh, do the canyon in honor of Mary Wilkinson, who absolutely smashed. The pro-am last night. If you haven't seen it, I'll stick a little link in the description, but head on over to Zwift Live on Facebook, Twitch, Mixer, YouTube, any of their social media channels, and you'll see last night's stream, which was one lap and a whole lot of lava for the pro-ams. And Mary, who is currently rocking the yellow Leaders GC jersey after one stage, absolutely smashed it and maintains and retains the yellow jersey with one more event to go in the series. But yeah, go and check that. Go and check that race out. Very, very exciting. Anyway, I'm going to spin back down to the bottom of the mountain now. And that's it for the stream, so thanks for joining in. Apologies that it cut off halfway through, or not halfway through, but a third of the way in. But thanks for joining in, thanks for the likes, thanks for the comments. As ever, I appreciate the support, so think about liking or subscribing or following or whatever you want to do on whichever one of the channels is your poison. So Facebook, Twitch, Mixer and YouTube. Make sure you sign yourself up for notifications so you know when new live streams go on air, and especially with what's happening outside at the moment, there's probably going to be a lot more racing indoors over the coming weeks, which means more streams. So anyway, thanks very much for joining in. Take care of yourselves, especially in terms of the virus. Be kind to each other. Right on.